to TWA's Battlefront, live at the Verizon Center in Washington, D.C. It is jam-packed, 20,000 people here.
All of whom I'm sure are bitter of the Capitals losing to the Rangers.
Hello everyone, RJ Peckham alongside my broadcast colleague Mark Adams. And tonight, Mark, we're going to see a lot of events unfold in the aftermath of the unfinished business pay-per-view, most notably Invisible Man's long-awaited return, as he just popped up from out of the ring and chokeslammed the Stalker after the main event was over. But as of right now, this is how the current King of the Tube standings is follows. Gigant is in first place, whereas Leatherface is just scraping the bottom at number 16. Every win counts, Mark, because with each win, you gain entry in the tournament.
Enough of that.
Here's the return of the Invisible Man.
The dark days are finally over here. If you ask me, he should just forget about Stalker and just move on and maybe even get into that race for the TWA title.
Well, he's going to have to rack up some wins first. I have reason to believe, Adams, that it's not about titles at this point for the Invisible Man.
Why not?
Because the Invisible Man only has one thing on his mind, and that's revenge. He's gonna take the mics, Invisible Man. I don't know who he's gonna sit.
Fresh air at last. I hope none of you take oxygen for granted. After smelling nothing but smoke, fire, and charred flesh for 5 months, you'd be ecstatic to smell clean air again. 5 months feels a lot longer than that. But nonetheless, I suffered in hell all that time because of you, Stalker, you evil, demonic villain. I used to care only about championships and fame. But now, all I want is my vengeance. Before the TWA shuts down, I will send you back home.
Oh, shit.
Yes, come to me, Stalker.
For you to meet your maker, you bastard.
Well, I would actually think the opposite, Mark. I think the Invisible Man is set to meet his maker. Stalker, he is not going to let what happened to him at Unfinished Business go unscathed.
Guarantee you, Invisible Man. I doubt he's scared of anything.
Oh, I doubt that he's scared too. He chokeslammed the Phenom right through the ring, and that was usually the Stalker's trademark.
Could have done a lot more too if it wasn't for Nazareth.
It was, of course, thanks to Nazareth that Invisible Man was not able to complete his full damage on the Dead Man. Nazareth came to the Stalker's aid. And you gotta think, what if Invisible Man has angered Nazareth as well by going after his brother? Will this only anger the Brothers of Destruction, as Invisible Man made a mistake?
I have only 2 months left to put you in the ground. We best get to work right now.
How you escaped hell baffles me. But as far as I'm concerned, you're still burning down there. Now leave my sight.
How did I escape hell, you ask? How do you think I escaped? There's only one being down there who can authorize that. And I believe you share the same blood type as him. He understood how powerful an invisible man could be. He sent me back to perform the task he's wanted to be completed for 2 years. Send his traitorous offspring back to hell, where he will punish them accordingly. And I intend to perform that task for him at Elimination Chamber.
I have nothing more to prove with you. I have other plans for that event.
Safina of the TWA is afraid of the Invisible Man. If you won't fight me at Elimination Chamber, perhaps Nazareth will.
He ran away.
Invisible Man just sent an ultimatum to the Stalker. Either he gets a match against him at Elimination Chamber, or Invisible Man is going to pick a fight with the Stalker's brother, Nazareth. The Invisible Man will do anything to get to the Stalker, even if it includes going through his brother.
I'd better call Indy. I found a fossil.
That's right. Keep laughing. By the end of tonight's show, you'll be crying in pain.
Let me guess. That means I'm facing Superman tonight, right?
That is correct. But I'm also adding in a special stipulation. It'll be a King of the Tube double or nothing points match, which, according to the standings, would mean that he will boost up to 16 points, and you'll stay at a pathetic 10 points. And hopefully, by the time the tournament hits, 10 points won't be enough to qualify, and you will be on the sidelines watching Clark become unprecedented King of the Tube.
I'm sorry, were you still speaking? Bullshit makes me sleepy.
Get out, you Weisenheimer! And hey, good luck against Superman.
Well, we're gonna start off with festivities here tonight, as the Wet Bandits, unsuccessful in trying to wrest the TWA Tag Team titles from Brute Force at Unfinished Business, are now going to take on a team that did pull off a victory at Unfinished Business, Jason Voorhees and Michael Myers. And with the way Jason and Michael pulled off the win over Freddy and Leatherface, they were so impressive that I think a win here tonight for either one of these teams could put them further in line for a shot at the tag titles.
The following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Chicago, Illinois, at a total combined weight of 382 pounds, the Wet Bandits.
Even though these guys can't win anything, maybe they'll be able to take the pain from Jason and Michael, because we've seen them go through all kinds of horrible punishment before.
And their opponents, first from Camp Crystal Lake, weighing in 275 pounds, Jason Voorhees!
The Wet Bandits suffered their most humiliating defeat when they lost to Brute Force in roughly 9 seconds. The shortest tag team title match in TWA's history. Probably the shortest title match, period. If they could beat Jason and Michael here tonight, it would be an impressive feat to get themselves back in the Tag Team Championship race.
And his partner from Haddonfield, Illinois, weighing in at 251 pounds, Michael Myers!
Both of these individuals have earned their spot in TWA immortality. Jason Voorhees being the very first TWA heavyweight champion. Michael Myers established himself as a force for many years with the Michael Myers Challenge at Halloween Haunt. Now these two forces come together. They swapped through Freddy Krueger and Leatherface at Unfinished Business. Now they're on to larger pursuits. The Wet Bandits are not going to have any size advantage here.
Or technical advantage. Or speed advantage.
And already, Jason is wiping the floor with Harry. And now here comes the tag to Michael Myers. Oh! Double chokeslam time! And that could have been it right there, but Harry punches Michael right below the belt, but he's greeted with a tilt-a-whirl slam for his efforts. Hard uppercut. Harry already taking a massive beating. Not only are Jason and Michael winning the match, they're also winning based on work operating as a team. Jason and Michael have already made two tags. Harry and Marv made none. Oh, but there's a blind tag, and Harry's a little pissed at that. Here's the tag. And now Marv's going for the ride. Don't tell me. Double superplex? Oh, and you could hear Marv screaming on the way down. That's got to be it. One, two. Oh, but Harry saves the day. Marv continues to scream as Jason gets knocked over on the apron, and Michael catches him from behind with the vice grip. And that's gotta be it. Michael and Jason have been playing with the wet bandits like a man playing with children. One, two, Harry saves the day, but they're not getting any offense in whatsoever. Finally, there's an uppercut. Hard kick, just above the belt. Referee Charles Robinson would have seen if it was below the belt. Tilt-a-whirl slam. And now, hard shot, Harry goes down. And wait a minute, Michael had the chance to put away Marv, but instead he's going after Harry. Way on the concrete.
I guess he figures that as long as Harry is standing, he's gonna keep breaking up Michael's pin attempts.
Well, Harry is laid out on the outside. Marv's gonna have to think of something all by himself to get the win. Harry's back up, but now Jason's tagged in, and now he's gonna feast. And here comes Crystal Lake Cross. Michael tackles Harry. There's a pin. One, two, three. Jason and Michael are the winners.
Here are your winners, Michael Myers and Jason Voorhees.
That took way longer than it should have. That should have been over in 30 seconds.
Well, the Wet Bandits hung in there for a little while longer, but it still wasn't enough to go over Jason Voorhees and Michael Myers. These two forces, I think they're getting slowly set for a tag team championship run. I don't report to you, RJ. Anyway, directly behind me is Super Mario's locker room. He was the first superstar to arrive tonight, and as soon as he arrived, he stormed into his room, and he hasn't come out since. Anybody who has tried to check out on him or try to talk to him has been greeted with a rude get out from him. If you ask me, he's just being a whiny baby. He's just upset just because the great Mario lost a few matches. If you're so upset, Mario, then why don't you do yourself all of us a favor and retire like all your friends? You hear me, loser? Retire! Back to you, RT.
I just feel like decking Vince so badly. Like, what the nerve he has to say such an insulting term to one of the greatest individuals TWA's ever had. Mario set the betrayal for what TWA is today, and Vince just disrespects him.
Maybe we could get some clarification as to what illegal activities Sonya did to Kubrick backstage at Unfinished Business.
There was nothing illegal going on.
How do you know?
Sonya Blade simply was just making things even.
Don't be proud of shallow and arbitrary victory at Unfinished Business, Jack. I have spoken to Rich Uncle Pennybags about what happened that night, and your victory is currently being reviewed. After all, you blatantly attacked the official multiple times. There's no just a cause why a decision should not be returned. Furthermore, I have also pressed charges against Sonya Blade for detaining and then proceeding to attack me. And I do believe this workforce has strict laws against intergender violence. So a suspension should be in order for her. Now, as it pertains to you, Jack, Alex is willing to compete one last time with you so we can put away this feud. But I must be allowed at ringside for this to happen. So predictable, it is not even funny. I beat Alex at Unfinished Business, and if you want to have the decision reversed, then fine. I'll accept your offer and face it in the rubber match. But this will be the deciding fight. Then I want it to be your last match, Alex. I literally want you to burn in hell at the end of this series. Now, what stipulation would ensure that? How about an inferno match? You're bloody mad, Jack. A hardcore match wasn't enough for you? You're still standing, so yes, it wasn't good enough for me. Alright, Jack, please listen. That is going way too far. I know you two dislike each other, but this is just competitive sport, not a fight to the death. Don't bother reasoning with me. You had plenty of time to do that before. See you in hell, Alex.
I'm surprised Alex and Kubrick didn't sneak attack Jack Torrance from behind, but it looks like we could possibly have an inferno match to decide this feud once and for all between Jack Torrance and Alex DeLarge. I'm through playing around, sir. I only have 2 months left to win the TWA title, so quit throwing your meaningless drag at me and put me in the Elimination Chamber now. I'm sorry, but you did not impress me when you lost to Nazareth. I don't give a damn. I want that TWA title, even if I have to tear my own body apart. I'm truly sorry, but another person already claimed your spot. And who is the bloody wanker that did that?
Poor choice of words.
That spot is mine, Bond.
What did you do to deserve it? Lose to Chuck Norris?
Okay, okay. I know how to resolve this. You two can face each other in a qualifier. Then nobody can complain to me that I was not being fair.
Fine. I've always had a distaste for you anyway. Two birds with one stone.
Good evening, Doctor.
Count Dracula, my cousin has told me a lot about you.
Don't remind me of that annoying pest. I see that you have regained control of your monster. It won't last long, though.
I beg your pardon?
You humans always want to have control over the things you create. You expect your creations to be obedient slaves. Then they run off, betray you, and then they go join Freddy Krueger. Isn't that right, Frankie?
I assume you have a point you would like to get across.
No matter how hard you try, you cannot control life. What will you do when you take Karras' skull and make him immortal? And he betrays you. You will have created an unkillable beast. One who answers to nobody. And now, I take my leave.
Well, coming up next, we've got Dracula against Karras. Now this will be a very interesting matchup because both of these men have an axe to grind with Frankenstein. But on the same token, both men shared partnerships and friendships with Frankenstein. Frankenstein was, of course, a former tag team champion alongside Dracula. Frankenstein and Karras were tag team partners for multiple months. This is going to be interesting.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Egypt, weighing in at 250 pounds, Karras.
Looks like he's ready.
His opponent, from Transylvania, weighing in at 228 pounds, Count
Dracula!
Crowd in Washington is getting all hyped. Every time Dracula comes out to the ring, even though he's undead, he's brought a new wave of optimism in his career. And it certainly helped. He became primetime champion last year, defeating his former partner Frankenstein for that belt. Here we go. Two undead monsters. Karras wants to put Dracula away to prove he is serious about getting in the ring with Frankenstein at Elimination Chamber. Also, I heard that James Bond and the Stalker are going to be going one-on-one later tonight. So what does that mean in terms of the Invisible Man? Gonna want Nazareth tonight, or is he?
It tells me that Stalker really is scared, and he's trying everything he can to avoid a match with the Invisible Man.
Karras is pushing Dracula around. Karras really pushing Dracula around momentarily. Dracula gets back in the ring. Dracula is, of course, a fighting competitor. He was the last man eliminated from the 2011 Royal Rumble.
You know what? Here's what Invisible Man should do. If Stalker's gonna try and get in the chamber to avoid him, then he should try and get a chamber qualifier match, so that way he'll still get him.
Well, I don't know how Invisible Man's relationship is with Rich Uncle Pennybags, so... he's gonna have to think of something on his feet right now, since the Elimination Chamber is roughly a couple of weeks away or so. Dracula tossing Karras to the side. There's a headbutt. Karras now seems to be having a hard time against the veteran Dracula. And there's the ankle lock. And I don't know why Dracula locked it a little more. He could have gotten the victory. There's a dreaded chop right to the throat. Dracula is just being slow and methodical in the pace. There's a hard hit from behind by Karras. Karras is now back on offense. I don't know if there's a match made official between Frankenstein and Karras at the Elimination Chamber, but... maybe we should throw in some gas chambers. Maybe we can call it the Intoxication Chamber again. Remember that event?
I'd rather not. And hopefully, since we have yet to get another call from the TWAR, it sounds like they're finally dead. And hopefully if it stays that way for 2 more months, then we'll be out of the clear for good.
What if the rejects follow us to our new deal that you've unveiled, which I don't know who this new company is we're dealing with, but what if the rejects follow us there? One, two.
Well, they couldn't, because that's where we're going is real competition.
And Dracula with the Kamala lock, and Karras could be tapping out at a moment's notice. He's just yanking on the arm, but really weakened him.
The new people we're dealing with would never take the time to work with those idiots.
Thing is, though, didn't the whole TWAR roster go down in that Zeppelin attack?
Yes, but... well, so far they've been dead for a while, but you never know with that place.
And Karras, oh, there's the Thoth pile driver. Down goes Drac. 1, 2, 3. A bit of a slow count, but Karras is the victor.
You shall winner, Karras!
Karras doesn't have any time to celebrate.
You're not gonna give me the squirrel, are you?
Maria,
I had hoped it wouldn't have to come to this.
My monster challenges you at this so-called Elimination Chamber event. The winner gets the Scroll of Thoth. Nothing more, nothing less.
Well, okay, it's on.
And, oh! Frankenstein's monster just appeared from behind. There's a brain chop.
Karras, you had to have seen that coming. What is he doing now?
Frankenstein actually going high risk? Going to the top rope? A top rope brain chop.
Well, good work, but you won't get a cheap shot like that at Elimination Chamber.
Well, if Frankenstein can utilize the brain chop from the top rope, I don't know what to say for Karras. I mean, he could be in trouble, especially with that doctor at his side.
Yes, what is it?
Great news, Maggot! I just negotiated with Pennybags long and hard! And he's putting you in the Elimination Chamber match!
Is this true, sir?
Yes. You ain't alright. Indiana Jones, and now I got you in the chamber.
Well, thank you, Ammo. I guess you did keep your word.
Yes, yes, I'm so happy for you. You can all leave now. You're sure this is just a ruse, right?
Uh-huh. I got a plan, sir. Don't worry.
Your plan better work. That man is undefeated, and I don't want him anywhere near Clark.
Whoa! Hi, it's Vince. I guess you don't see every day. Or, actually, you do, kinda. Whatever, I'm here with Death. So, Mr. Grim Reaper, it sounds like the Invisible Man who has just returned is out to kill your charges, Nazareth and the Stalker. Do you have 2 cents that you'd like to put in?
That Satan. He was a coward on Earth, and he is still a coward in Hell. I was the one who sent him to the Ninth Circle, and he wishes to take his fury out on his biological sons. It's me you want, Satan. Leave those two be. Tell your new slave, the Invisible Man, to come after me. I will put him and you in your place.
Wow. Sham wow. Some creepy words, but what the hell's going on? I'm out of here.
You are on my list too, Reaper.
And from the looks of it, Death was just attacked by the Invisible Man. He got his head rammed through, I think it was that same car that Invisible Man smashed Rocky Balboa's head into about a year ago.
They really mean business.
And now, well, these two got it on at unfinished business. The current women's champion Samus and the returning Katniss Everdeen. The match was ended by double disqualification after Metal Queen ran in and assaulted both divas. And needless to say, neither one of these divas looked too happy. And look like they're finally here to address Metal Queen's interference.
Metal Queen, why is it every time I condone you for your feats and accomplishments, you go and do something that infuriates me and makes me wish I could take back all the nice things I said about you?
I could tell right from my first lockup with Katniss that we were going to have an historic 5-star match, and you came out and ruined it.
If you wanted a rematch with me, then why didn't you ask for one before I gave Katniss her opportunity? Or did you just want to get her hopes up and then crush them?
I'm absolutely disgusted with you. Let's hear how Katniss feels about this.
I come back after saving Pan Am to win back the woman's title, and this is the outcome I get?
I would have rather screamed, "I quit," and lost fairly than receive a double disqualification. I don't know what happened to you while I was gone, but the Metal Queen that I knew, the Metal Queen I respected and admired, is clearly dead.
Rather have seen Metal Queen.
Yep, Santina is in the race for the women's title. She won the right to be number one contender after she beat Catwoman in an upset at Unfinished Business.
Yeah, well, just because she beat Catwoman doesn't mean she should be so confident that she'll confront these two.
Look, I know you're the next contender, but this is not the right time.
Guys, I know it sucks that you never got to have an actual title match. But like you said, I'm the next contender, and I would like to get my title match before this place closes.
With all due respect, I believe Katniss deserves another shot before you step in.
And when will that be? Sorry, girl, but my time is now. I trained for months to get this far, and now that I am so close to my dream, I ain't letting anything stop me. Sorry, Katniss, but you had your shot. Now it's my turn.
Everyone relax! I have a plan that will fix all of this! You remember when I said equality? That's my motto. When asked about the women's division? Well, here's what I have planned. For the month of June, not only will we have the King of the Two to look forward to, we will also have the first, and dare I say, only time in TWA history, the Queen of the Two Tournament. Four of TWA's Estrogen Elite will go the distance to not only be crowned Queen of the TWA, they will face you, Samus, in the very last Women's Championship match at End of Days in July. And the fourth participants will be none other than Katniss, Santina, Metal Queen, and of course, Catwoman. You see, TWA World, in just half a year, I have done more for TWA's divas than any other GM in history. That alone should make you all like me and support my plans. Thank you. You're a beautiful audience. Wait a minute. How is Catwoman even in the number one contender's race? She lost fair and square to Santina. Santina should be getting that title shot.
Well, I don't care. As long as Metal Queen's in, I'm happy.
Well, Queen of the Two Tournament, it's a mini tournament where we'll see four divas go at it.
Oh! Ah! Scheiße!
Oh my god! Check out! Check out! Oh my god! Get help! I'm sorry, Maggot! You were in my blind spot!
Blind spot? Emma was the one who ran over Gigant! What a freaking liar he is!
I'm being told we're currently having problems with our chroma key, so we don't have a match card to show you, but up next is Jaws versus Freddy in an Elimination Chamber qualifier.
Well, this is going to be interesting. Freddy lost the title to Chuck Norris, the TWA Championship at Telethon in the main event, and Freddy wants to get any opportunity he can to get the title back. But he's going to have to go through Jaws to do it, and that is no easy feat.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Poland, weighing in at 343 pounds, Chaz!
Jaws is definitely a favorite to win this match. And if he goes through and beats Freddy Krueger, he could be considered a possible odds-on favorite to win the TWA Championship for the second time. For any man who was able to become King of the Tube and TWA World Champion in the same night, that person must know the meaning of main event.
If I could go back to what happened earlier backstage. Ammo, do you think we're fucking stupid? How could your blind spot be right in front of your damn face?
Can't believe that piece of garbage lied to Gigant once again. Helps him win the light heavyweight title, this is the thanks he gets.
And his opponent, accompanied by Leatherface, weighing in at 210 pounds, the entity, Freddy Krueger!
What is Leatherface still doing with him?
Freddy has been on a horrid losing streak, as a matter of fact, since he lost the TWA title to Chuck Norris at Telethon, the main event.
I still don't understand. Why is Leatherface with him after he beat him up at the end of their tag match?
Well, don't ask me, I don't know. Monsters have strange bonds. Freddy Krueger wants to end his losing streak right now. But Jaws is one opponent that's going to make life miserable, hellish, for the Nightmare on Elm Street.
If Freddy wins this and goes to the chamber, even though Pennybags and Freddy are both on the dark side, I wonder if Pennybags would really approve of having Freddy be his last TWA champion.
Well, he approved of Freddy being the TWA champion for as many months as he did. Freddy with a hard elbow.
Okay, so if my memory serves me right, I think so far who we have qualified is Superman, who didn't have a qualifier, he was just thrown in, Bugs Bunny, Captain Rhodes, maybe Gigant, and whoever wins this one.
Well, it's highly unknown if Gigant is even going to make it into the chamber after we just saw him being run over with the car that very clearly Ammo was driving. Jaws with a hard kick to the back.
So would this determine the fifth slot or the sixth slot?
This is fifth. Sixth is going to be later tonight with Bond and the Stalker.
A very interesting matchup for sure. Freddy keeps raking the face of Jaws.
Did Leatherface just pull Freddy's leg?
Freddy just blatantly choking Jaws, and referee Mike Chioda not doing anything about it. And once again with the choking. Come on, ref, you're just standing there like you're cryogenically frozen or something.
Jaws with a hard boot.
Oh, but don't worry, he's consistent. He gave Jaws a talking to for those boots to the face.
I mean, I swear, the officiating's been pretty shoddy lately. It's one of the reasons why Ammo defeated Indiana Jones for the light heavyweight title. Freddy just knocked Leatherface's own charge off the apron. One, two, no! Freddy almost got it done with the nightmare. Leatherface goes after Jaws after Freddy knocks him off the ropes. That doesn't make any sense. And why isn't it a disqualification? And Jaws with the shoulder switch power slam.
Leatherface just keeps looking.
And now Jaws gonna try to break Freddy's ankle. This could be it. This could be it.
Leatherface isn't helping.
Leatherface is just leaving Freddy. I think he's finally had enough. And Freddy taps. That's it. Jaws is the winner. Jaws is going to the chamber.
Who's your winner? Jaws!
Freddy almost surprised Jaws with the nightmare, but thanks to all that dilly-dallying with Leatherface, I think he cost himself the match. Freddy is shocked to find that Leatherface is not around. Now, Leatherface, he's running back to the ring, and it looks like Leatherface has finally had it up to here with Freddy Krueger, and he just puts knots in his head. And looks like Freddy has done the unthinkable, Mark. He has managed to alienate every one of his friends. And now Freddy is going to live to regret this. If Leatherface does get his hands on Freddy Krueger, it will not be pretty. I can assure you that.